Hello guys, Zul'jin here. Welcome back to another episode of ARK Survival Evolved. Guys, thank y'all so much for all the support on the ARK series. As always, if you do enjoy the videos, make sure to give me some dap on that like button to show your support. You can also subscribe to the channel for more daily ARK videos. So guys, I got a real fun episode for you today. My buddy, that dude Chaos, is new to ARK, right? He doesn't know a whole lot about the taming process and stuff, and I just got enough levels to where I can make a trike saddle. So guess what we're gonna do? We're gonna get our first trike. Yep, our first workhorse. We're gonna slingshot tame it and get it up so we can start forming narco berries and narco arrows and all that other stuff. So sit back and I'll introduce you to Chaos. All right, guys, this is TDC, otherwise known as That Dude Chaos. You could just call him Chaos or TDC or Tutica, as some people call him.
But you can call me whatever you want.
Welcome to the server, man.
Thank you.
So you're kind of new to ARK, and you don't know a whole lot about the taming process, and I happen to be a Beastmaster.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, kind of. All right, so have you gotten a slingshot yet?
I got a slingshot. We are there, and I've got 58 stone. Is that going
to
be enough?
Oh, yeah, that should be. So we're going to go trike hunting. I just got enough levels to where we can actually tame a trike. And, well, we can actually saddle a trike. We can make a trike saddle. So the mission objective is to knock down a trike, feed it enough berries to tame it, make a saddle for it, put the saddle on it, and use it. That's the mission objective. So
gotcha.
I hope that works pretty good. So the slingshots do torpor damage, and if you notice, if you look at your own stats at the bottom right hand corner of the screen, you'll see torpor 0 out of 200.
Yeah,
so these stats are different for every animal. Like a level 100 Rex might have 10,000 torpor.
Ooh,
that
okay.
Number might be a little large, but it's just to give you an idea. So rocks, I'm gonna go ahead and hit you with a slingshot right here, and I'll show you kind of what it's like. So look at your torpor damage. You're in your inventory.
I am now.
All right.
Okay.
Now you see that? Your torpor is going up. It doesn't do a whole lot of damage, but it does torpor damage. So tranquilizer arrows do a whole lot more than that, and you get even more so in headshots. So what we're going to be trying to do is use slingshots on a trike in the head to get its torpor up high enough to where it goes unconscious. Then once it's unconscious, we'll be able to move on to feeding it and start the taming process.
Gotcha.
So let's see here if we can find any trikes. They're usually everywhere, and I don't want to get us into too much trouble. Let's see here. So how do you like the game so far? Pretty dangerous.
So far,
huh?
It's pretty cool. Yeah, when y'all said it was rough, y'all weren't kidding.
Yeah, it's brutal. Now, granted, like the levels and stuff, we're playing on max difficulty from the start. Normally when servers can start up until people are established, we could have played on a much lower difficulty level where the dino ranges are 1 to 30. But early on, we were getting attacked by like level 90 stuff, and you can't really kill those without being prepared well. All right, this is a trike. We need to check out what level it is. Let's see. Oh, and it happens to be glitched, it looks like, which is going to be great. So every once in a while, you'll see how they kind of get stuck. It may not be stuck, but sometimes it gets stuck around the trees. So let's see. There's a rock right here that it might not be able to climb. Let's do this. Let's try something. We can always just kite it, but we should probably just try to stick it from here. So, ready?
Okay.
Aim. Fire.
Okay.
So it is stuck. So we shouldn't have to worry about a whole bunch. You might have to get a little bit of arc on it. Looks like your rocks are dropping.
Oh, okay.
And drawback has a lot to do with it, too. So when your hand starts shaking a little bit, like your aim starts moving around, that's usually full draw.
Okay.
Bows are kind of the same way. It looks like there's a dillo right there, too. We might, when this thing drops. Now, this is a level 40, so this is going to be a little bit long to tame, but it's going to be a really good tame when we get it up. The level ranges increase its base stats. And I'll show you a little bit more about what happens when you actually get it down. There's something called taming effectiveness. And basically, every time it eats, that taming effectiveness goes down a little bit, unless you feed it some of its favorite foods.
Huh.
For these, it happens to be medjool berries, which are the purple berries. For most of the herbivores, it does. For cornos, like, you have prime meat, and there's also kibble and stuff, too. Uh-oh, looks like some foam is dying. Alright, you see the blood on it? How it's starting to look really bloody?
Yeah.
This... Oh, yeah, that's it, that's it, that's it. Alright, perfect, we got it down. So, let's take out this, You got a spear on the bridge? Oh, no, I have a bow, never mind. I just want to take out this, this dildo so it doesn't get any ideas.
Okay. I'm gonna have to change some settings real quick. I'm getting like 20 frames or 15 frames a second.
Alright.
My computer hates this game.
A lot of people's computer hates this game.
It's crazy, man.
Yeah, it's pretty nuts, man. Alright, buddy. So this one's down. Now, this is what you basically want to do. You see how it has, if you go close enough to it, you see a bar on it that says unconscious?
Yeah.
And it says put food in inventory to tame. So, if you take a stack of Mejo berries and just put them in there, put all your Mejos in there, it's going to start eating. Now,
okay.
It has a food meter, too. You can see, like, the food, the numeric value on the food is, like, 38.92. When it gets down to about, I think it's 15 per berry. Let's see. No, it might be 20 points per berry. When it drops down by 20 points... Or maybe even more, maybe even 30 points. Anyway, it eats. And every time it eats, this taming bar goes up a little bit. So you'll see it has a little bit of brown.
Yeah.
Taming effectiveness is 84 because it probably took a little bit of damage when you hit it with that rock afterwards. But basically what's going to happen is if it tames out at this level, it's going to tame out with 16 levels. So it'll be a level 56 in total.
Oh, okay.
Now, its torpor is going down this whole time, so its unconsciousness level is dropping slowly. When it gets all the way down, it'll wake up. You lose all the taming effectiveness and everything else. It stops taming, pretty much. So you counteract this with narco berries. So you could put narco berries in its inventory and hit remote use item. And its torpor is going to go up every time you do that by a certain amount. So... Basically, you have to just keep it unconscious until it eats enough for the taming bar to get to 100% and it gets up and it'll be under your control.
Gotcha. Okay.
So now, typically, all we have to do is make sure that we harvest enough Mejo berries and stuff. Now, you could use other kind of berries too, but the Mejo berries are its favorite food. There's something called kibble as well that we'll get into later, but basically, it's a much more effective way of taming. And you gotta make it in a cooking pot and stuff. But anyway, what we should probably do is just make sure we have enough Mejo berries with this guy, and we can start looking at the requirements for a saddle here. So when I look at Trike's saddle, let's see, hide is 110 that I need. So I got enough fiber and wood to make this. Oh, this is a raptor saddle, actually. This is the trike saddle. I still need more hide, so we probably just need to get probably about 120 hide, and we should be good to make a saddle for it when it gets up.
Okay, I've got 30-ish.
Okay, cool. That'll definitely help. Looks like there's a dealer right here that we can kill.
You got a bow and arrow. That's nice. Yeah. I haven't crafted one of those yet, so.
Oh, you definitely need to craft one, man. They are awesome.
Now, okay, so another, I guess, a newbie question, too, is, like, some tools harvest different things more than others, right?
Yep.
What's the best tool to use to get hide?
So, hide is an axe.
An axe. Yep. Okay, and then, like,
pick
for
is
meat?
For meat, right.
Okay.
Just like, you'll also get more wood with an axe on trees and more thatch on wood from a pick.
Okay.
On rocks, you get your pick will give you more flint, whereas an axe will give you more stone. They still yield both all the time, but you'll just get more from the other.
Okay.
And there's a Meganora on the floor right there. Let's see, what do I need for a one of these things here? I need a little bit of flint here. Now, the taming is a little bit cranked up on our server, too. It's not nearly as fast on public servers.
Yeah.
Some servers, they have it amplified, but for the most part, it's relatively slow.
You didn't worry about this guy?
No. Yeah, it's all right. The pig mole, we call them.
Pig mole.
They're perfectly harmless.
Okay.
Do you have any Mejo berries on you?
I don't think so. Nope, I don't have anything. I've got stem berries, tinto berries, and the yellow ones. And 12 narcos.
Okay, cool.
So how do you get Mejo berries? Just from bushes? Like?
Oh. Yep. You just form them up just by pressing E on bushes, and you'll get them as you go. So we'll probably need a few more to give to it. I was going to say, while we have one trike down, we might as well get a second trike down, too. Since we're going to do this and we're going to be out here, we might as well get each a one, you know?
Okay.
So what I could do here, there's a few trikes over here, but as a mechanic, you have to be careful for a name mate boosted. When a male and female are around each other, they'll defend each other, and they also get a buff called mate boosted. It works on your tamed animals, too, so... it makes them significantly tougher than when they're singled out. So you have to be very careful. Like these, there'd be three of them that would be on us, but I'm kind of just looking at levels here. Here's level 12. You see that heart over it? See how it has a heart above its name? That means it's mate boosted.
Okay. So you don't want to touch those.
No.
Until we're higher level.
Right. There is one over here. We should be able to tame this guy, but we're going to have to... Oh, this one's considered mate boosted because of the trike that's on the ground over there that we already got.
Hmm.
We might have to lure it away a little bit. Let's see. Level 32? What we don't want to do is let it attack the... let it come anywhere around this tame to do damage to it. We might...
Oh, so they can hurt each other?
Yeah, they can hurt each other. And when... When something gets damaged like that, too, their effectiveness goes down. Oh, look, a little Mesopithecus, a little monkey. All right, let's see what we can do here. I guess we can lead this guy a little bit further away over here. I'm going to go ahead and draw it in with a rock, and we'll see what it'll do.
Okay.
All right, is anything else
coming? So just keep shooting it?
Yep, yep. Just kite. Don't let it hit you. It's probably going to take this similar amount of time to get it down.
Oh, I got bugs on me.
Uh-oh.
Oh.
Oh, no.
Oh.
It killed you?
No, I'm not dead.
All right.
Not yet, anyway.
All right, I'll try to get this thing's attention off of you.
Oh. This game is rough.
Yep.
Now, I was talking a little bit earlier, too.
It's after you.
I'm running. Okay, slingshot. Shoot it in the head. Okay, he's the other way now.
Yeah, he's after
you. Like, do we need to worry about killing him with the slingshot, or is that something...
It's possible. It's just very unlikely.
It just take a long time?
Yeah, very unlikely. Okay, it looks like it's kind of stuck. That's beautiful.
Yeah.
Oh, no, I broke my stuff.
Oh, mine's about to break, too.
I can repair it. I got enough stuff on it to repair it. If you just hit the hot button, it'll repair it for you.
Oh, okay.
Uh-oh, it got unstuck. Watch it. It's coming at you. Look, come up on this rock, buddy.
Oh. Oh, he hurts.
Yep. Oh, I'm out of stone. Careful, he might try to come up here.
Yep.
Ouch.
Whoa. Whoa.
I died.
I died too.
All right. The worst thing about that is that we actually have to make it back to where we were. But anyway, Tony's like, All right, guys, we'll be back. All right, buddy. He's got one more feeding. So I think it's every 30 points he goes down, and he's at 75, 74, 73, 72, 71. Tame.
Woo!
All right, man. What do you want to name him? It's your trike.
How do we name him?
So if you just go to, if you hold the E on it.
Okay.
And then just change
rename. Oh, change name.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. What's a good,
You can't go for something cliche like Sarah from the...
Exactly what I was going for.
Everybody names their trike Sarahs, man.
Oh, man.
Is it a male or a female? It's a male, so it has to be a male name, too.
The spike probably pretty cliche too, huh?
Well, I haven't seen any spikes, so that's probably pretty good.
We'll go with Spike.
All right.
Except.
Yay! Hello, Spike. Welcome. All right, so there's a few things you could do to it. You can hold E on it and change its disposition. So, like, cycle aggression to neutral, set to aggressive, enable following, change targeting range. Mostly what I do is these four keys right here. T. And if you point at something and press T, it'll whistle, and it's a follow whistle. If you point at something and press Y, it's an unfollow whistle.
Okay.
Okay. And there is also, if you hold the T button, you'll get a radial menu, and you'll be able to whistle neutral and whistle passive. So let's say something's attacking Spike, and it's not fighting back because it's on passive for whatever reason. You can whistle, attack my target. Okay?
Oh, okay.
Or whistle neutral, and it'll start fighting back. If something if it's hitting on something and you want it to stop, for instance, you might just hit whistle passive. This whistle is everything around you, though, that belongs to your tribe. So there's also an all follow and an all stop following, which are U and J. So J means all follow me too. But if there was 10 dinosaurs around, they would all be following me. And
gotcha.
U means all unfollow. So there you go.
Gotcha.
So the cool thing about having a dino like this, first of all, we need to get a saddle for it because it gives it defense and you can ride it. But what you can do is just find something to attack it. Watch this. Let's see here. I'll grab this guy over here. So he's going to be... this might be another tame force right here. I don't know what level it is, but there's another trike coming anyway. We'll see about that. All right, so when they get close, you can whistle attack this target, and the dino is going to jump into action here. Get him, Spike. Oh, Spike's stuck. So can you get it out of that tree?
How do I do that?
Just break the tree.
Oh, knock the tree?
Yeah.
Oh, my axe broke.
Oh no, pickaxe.
Okay, we got this.
All there right, get him, Spike. So Spike will tank.
Okay.
And we can go ahead and around the backside and do our little damage.
Oh.
And this is a great way to level and get experience. Oh.
Ooh.
There it is.
Whoa. There's another one.
There's another one, too. There's spikes all over that, man.
Woo.
Nice.
Dude,
just heal two.
That's awesome.
It's very cool having a trike, man. Very, very cool. The coolest thing about trikes, too, is they're not the best dinos in the world, but they have the ability to harvest berries and thatch a lot faster than we do with regular tools. So yeah. What are we looking like on the hide situation here? I have only 12.
I have 77.
All right, that should be enough here. Let me grab some hide off of this one. You can harvest that one.
Okay, over I gotta there. Make another axe.
And let's see what I need for this saddle here. We can also upgrade our armor pretty soon too. Let's see, hide 140 I'll need, and wood 25, which wood 25 is very easy. Okay, and I'll harvest this guy. Alright, and if you want to give me all of the hide that you have, I'll go ahead and make this, this saddle. All I need is about 30.
I dropped it.
Oh,
is that it behind you?
There it is. Got it. All right.
Okay.
And so let's see. I'll go ahead and craft it. And this is going to give us some XP too. Trike saddle. Make sure it's the right one. All right.
Okay.
And I got a level for it. Okay. Here's the trike saddle. So go ahead and access its inventory.
And that's F, right? There's a shortcut into that?
Right.
Okay, yeah, got it.
Yep. And now put it in the saddle slot that it has.
Got it.
That's it. Now mount him up. All right. So you
can, no way.
Yeah. So you can hold shift to move faster. It's going to run out of stamina really quick. That's just one of the capabilities of the dino. And if you go to some berry bushes and just left click to attack, it'll harvest them up and it'll go directly into your dino's inventory.
Wow. Okay. Whoa. That's cool.
It's going to harvest really, really quick. And you can press F at any time to check the inventory of your dino, or you can have people go up to it too. So I'm carrying a lot of wood and meat here that I really don't need right now. So I'm going to go ahead and just put those on your dino to help carry some weight, the stone too. And also, the one great thing about dinos as well is that the spawn timers will be longer. So the these Azul berries, for instance, when I have them on me, the spawn timer is 9 minutes and 50 seconds. When I put them on the dino, they're 39 minutes and 15 seconds.
Oh.
So anything that you're trying to hold to store that has an expiration timer on it, the dinos can hold them longer.
Gotcha.
So now what we need to do is harvest up a bunch of narco berries so that we can make some narcotic arrows, some narc arrows, and tame some real big stuff.
That's when the fun happens.
Yeah,
huh?
Definitely, man. Well, that's about the episode. I hope you learned something today.
Yeah, that's going to take some repetition, but I think I'll get the hang of it.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, you got a good tool to start with.
Yeah. Well, I appreciate your help, man. I guess I'm a noob at this game, so I'm going to be taking as much help as I can get. So.
Well, you're welcome, man. It's fun.
It is a lot of fun.
All right, man. Enjoy it.
We'll see you back in base.
Yep. Check it out. We've already been putting together, everybody in the tribe has been working together, and look, we've got a smithy, a refining forge, plenty of beds, stone walls, a little bit of storage set up, we've got a couple of trikes out here, I think there was a couple of carnivores that were tamed too. I want to say that they got a raptor out, they tamed a carno, really, really cool stuff. So I don't know what I want to tame first, you guys. I thought about maybe going to the mountain and taming one of the Argentivus, but I'm not real sure. I'm going to have to look around. But anyway, guys, that is going to be it for this episode. I hope y'all really enjoyed it. There's Corrales right behind me. Thank you guys so much for watching. As always, this is Zul'jin signing off, and we'll see you next time.